Hi guys, it's your main pair here, and we are pleased to announce our very first cook-off competition in the DMC neighborhood. Everyone is welcome to take part, so without further ado, let me hand you over to Darren, so that he can tell you what this entails.
Thank you very much, my almond-crusted salmon. These are the rules of the cook-off. You must cook two different dishes for this event, one main dish and a cake. Each of your two dishes will receive a mark out of 5. While we allow you to get stuff from the supermarkets around the area, we also impose some limits as to what you can get.
For the cakes, you must already have the ingredients for the sponge, as we won't allow you to buy that. However, we will allow you to buy decorations for your cakes, such as sprinkles and anything else creative. For your main dish, you're allowed to get some ideas from the internet, but you must cite where you got your ideas from. Plagiarism will get you disqualified for that particular dish.
Also, you'll need to provide us with a small report of 200 words, telling us where you got your ideas from, and where you got your sources from, if you use the internet for your ideas. Anyways, we'll be pleased to announce that we will have a celebrity chef coming to visit the DMC neighborhood, and it's is none other than Gordon Ramsay himself.
We'll also have Anne Riordan judging your cakes. Say Darren, my sweet potato pie, this cook-off is going to be very exciting indeed. I can't wait to get this show on the road.
Nor can I, my Swedish meatball hero. So, without further ado, let's us get this cook-off on the road, and we look forward to seeing what dishes you come up with.
Now then, Mum, Dad and Emily. I invited you all over, because there is a cook-off taking place, and I thought we could submit our dishes the whole family. Darren has allowed family projects. So this is going to be very exciting indeed.
That is a brilliant idea, my baby. I can't believe that we get the chance to show off our dish to Gordon Ramsay. I mean, how amazing is that?
I agree with you there, Juliet. And also, we have Anne Riordan judging the cakes, which is an honor in itself. She's also joined the DMC Heroes, along with her husband.
Now then, we need to get ourselves a couple of dishes that are compelling and creative, so that we'd stand the chance against Gordon Ramsay's judging. He has 17 Michelin stars, so he's definitely a force to be reckoned with.
But you know, so long as we work together as a family unit, and we try our absolute hardest, that we'll be able to knock up something memorable. But just don't stick a chicken inside a pumpkin, like someone did on TikTok.
Adam, I remember watching that clip, my love, and believe me, it doesn't look appetizing to say the least. I actually thought it would have given that person salmonella, since you can't really cook a chicken effectively inside a pumpkin.
I remember seeing other clips as well where that very same person dunked chicken into peanut butter, wrapped it in white bread, and then covered it in biscuits and cinnamon crunch. I mean, where's the sense in that mess?
But guys, we're not going to go anywhere in this cook-off, if we just continue to talk about bad recipes on TikTok. Mind you, it does worry me, when it comes to what Gordon Ramsay has in mind for us.
That's true, Juliet. Now then, let's us get this show on the road, and see what dish we can come up with.
Same here, my summer peach surprise. How amazing is this? I can't get over the fact that we're going to take part in the very first DMC cook-off. Have you decided on what to cook yet?
I haven't thought of that yet, my juicy orange trifle. We also need to make a cake as well, because there are two different parts to this cook-off. You know what? I reckon we should look through our cookbook of recipes, and see the two ideal recipes we can find there.
There's just one thing though, my bread and butter pudding. How can we be done for plagiarism if we're using a recipe book of our ideas?
When a recipe book doesn't cite the sources you get the idea from, that could count as plagiarism. We need to make sure that we're 100% prepared, and that we can come up with something that's guaranteed to knock Chef Ramsay's socks off.
Hey, I'm looking forward to taking part in this cook-off. I'm going to come up with something from my native UAE, something I can hope to knock Gordon Ramsay's socks off.
Hey there. Well, Eid. It's great to see you, buddy. How are things going for you so far?
I'm doing well, thanks, Aiden. But I must ask, do you know of any ideas of where I can get some dishes based on my native UAE? I'm trying to find some inspiration, but it's actually quite difficult. I do, however, have a great idea for a cake, so at least that is taken care of.
If you want to, you can always look at our cookbook. It's as packed full of great ideas, which is guaranteed to blow your mind, and you would be really spoiled for choice.
That's true. It amazes me how many ideas we've come up with, and our collection is ever growing too, so you'll have a wide range of what to go for.
Now this is something worth noting. The Prasad Diamond has arrived to catch the excitement and... Oh my goodness. This is something I'm glad to be taking part in. Is this the cook-off that Darren was telling us all about?
Hey! It's great to see you, Neil. How has your day gone so far?
Say Mia, my honey-coated strawberry. Shall we all team together and come up with a collection of ideas for recipes? I'm sure we'll be able to think of something, and there are other people that want to contribute as well.
That's a brilliant idea, my chicken pasta bake. Come on, guys, let's us go and get some ideas together, and we'll get to see what happens. Now then, I bet you were wondering why I gathered you all in here. Darren has announced something very exciting, a cook-off for everyone inside the DMC neighborhood. To be perfectly honest, I am very excited indeed. I mean, how often do we get to show our cooking skills to Gordon Ramsay?
Have you got any ideas as to what we're going to cook? We all need to come up with a main dish and a cake. The main dish will be judged by Gordon Ramsay, and the cake will be judged by Ann Reardon. This is very exciting. I can't wait to get started.
I'm sure we'll be able to come up with something. Aiden and Mia have a cookbook full of surprises, and has said that we're able to have a look through it anytime we wish to. However, we need to ensure that we can come up with separate dishes, otherwise it may become a bit samey-jamey for Gordon Ramsay.
I think I might have a great idea as to what we can come up with. My breaded coated chicken. And, since Darren has allowed us to do a couple's dish, I reckon we can steal the show together.
That's a brilliant idea. My chocolate peanut brittle. But the question now is, what do we come up with? I'm sure we'll be able to find something, but we'll need to take a further look into this first.
You know what? I was wondering whether we should do something exotic, but Gordon Ramsay isn't too keen on pineapples. I'm thinking of the idea of a chicken korma. My creamy chicken korma. How does that idea sound?
I quite like the idea of that, my chicken crusted pizza. We'll make sure it's nice and creamy, and that it also has the flavors you could dream of.
Hey! I think I might have a perfect idea for what we can cook. I fancied the idea of making a chicken parmesan, but was wondering what you two think of the idea.
That's just sounding like a brilliant idea, Jamie. I was also wondering if you'd like to join me and Ellie for our dish. We were thinking about making a chicken korma, but I now suddenly like your idea too. Maybe we should come up with a vote and see which idea wins out.
Now remember, guys. Darren has allowed group projects as well, so I deeply encourage you to get into groups of two or three. Family members can perform in a group of an unlimited size, but they must elect a forerunner to promote their dish. The same is said for any groups that may form here too.
But remember that we also allow solo projects as well. However, because of the complications that may come with any dish, we need to advise those who are under the age of 15 to work in a group. This stops them from getting overwhelmed by the cook-off.
Say no, Vidrom. Can Holden and I work in a group with you, please? We're both under 15, and we're going to need some form of supervision, otherwise we may become overwhelmed.
Of course you can, Random Melon 303. We need to make sure that we stick together as a team. This will ensure that it all runs smoothly.
Says Larkson. Would you and Joni Kenna like to join me in a group? I think I might have a brilliant idea for a dish and would like to share it with you both.
I would love to, Tyler. Thanks for inviting me to take part. I can't wait to see what idea you've got for a dish.
It feels great to be part of a group. I can't wait to get this show on the road, and I believe I can contribute with a nice chocolate cake, but with some twists too.
Say Bobby, my love. How would you like the idea of making a fruit cake with me? We need to take certain restrictions into account though, since you're a dog, and I'm going to take the very best care of you.
Woof woof. That is a brilliant idea, Annie. I also have a brilliant idea for a main dish, and it is something friendly for both human and dog.
Now this will be very interesting indeed, Bobby. I look forward to hearing all about it.
I think I might do a solo project, unless of course, I can find someone else to team up with. This will help get the show on the road.
You can always team up with myself and Rainbow King if you wanted, Nanimator. We've always got room for one more, and we both believe that you've got some great ideas with what dish to make.
Of course. Thanks for the suggestion, Lozzy. I can't wait to get started, but we also need to come up with some sort of idea, and then we can put paper into action, once the ideas have been finalized.
Now then, I wonder what main and troublesome dishes we are to come up with? I've pulled a few stunners off TikTok, and I would like to share some of them with you.
I'm not sure what I can think of at the moment, Luke, but I'm sure you'll come up with something rather beautiful. I'm going to absolutely love this with a passion.
Not forgetting some of the recipes that we saw on 5 Minute Crafts too. They're going to be some showstoppers too. And by that, I mean, something so mean and powerful that they'll send Gordon Ramsay and Ann Reardon to the bathroom throwing up.
That is a brilliant idea, Adam, but can I remind you to use your indoor voice, please? We don't want to risk getting caught while we're up to no good.
Say, Luke, how are we going to distribute the groups? Daleks can't take part, as they're not exactly wired to be doing this sort of stuff. This then leaves us with 12, and wait, we get to outnumber the DMC heroes, because they've only got 9 people left competing since 4 of them are doing other things.
But then that begs the question, who else remains in the DMC heroes? I mean, Darren's hosting this cook-off, so you can't really expect him to do anything. Anne and Dave are judging the cakes, and Adam is cooking with his family and Dane.
Ooh, but then that figure becomes 7, as James will be cooking with his family, and Connor will most likely do something with Zoe. That leaves then, Bono and The Edge, Louis Theroux, Super Nanny, Brandon Hammers, Austin, and Kim Woodburn. They don't really stand a chance against us. Mwahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahah
Obviously, Dean and Adam will be cooking together, since they're married now, and with things set in stone, we're the group with the most number of people. No one will ever stand a chance against us. I also have a copy of Anne's book, which we can look at, and then pass the cakes off as our own.
But the question now is, how are we going to take care of that Daran clone? It should really be you who's hosting this cook-off since you're the real deal.
You know what? I never really gave it any thoughts. I tried something like that before, and Austin put me in my place. I can always try shape-shifting, but before I do even that, I can slip the other me a concoction of spicy foods and confine him to the toilet for an extended period of time.
But I'm sure something like that happened before as well. Bessie Thatcher received that same treatment when Adam fed her cold and spicy lumpy potatoes, and then added fish to the mix as well. If we're going to cause some trouble, we need to try something different.
But how else do we plan on taking the DMC neighborhood down through some sort of cook-off? I know. How's about I introduce a charging scale on the food that is available in the supermarkets? That way, the cook-off never goes ahead after all, and then we can laugh our way into the bank, both figuratively and literally.
You know what? That is a brilliant idea, Rishi. I can't get over the quality of your suggestion. There's going to be so much we can do to overthrow this pathetic excuse of a neighborhood, and we're going to do this with style.
We can always turn bloodthirsty, and literally turn all chocolate into blood. That'll make things more action-packed.
That's a sounding like a rather dangerous idea. You get an A+ from me, Jason. I can't believe that I'm in a group where I finally belong. I just hope that Matt the Go Animator doesn't have anything to say about this.
Now then, with the groups, we need to split into 4 groups of 3, and we need to have one of each fake and evil clone in separate groups. This may sound crazy, but it's the only way where we'll get the numbers even with the fakery and evil that's is about to spread all over this neighborhood.
That is a brilliant idea, Brianna. Come on, guys, let's us now divvy up into groups, and then all evil can assume from here.
Hey guys. What a day this has turned out to be. I mean, we get the chance to wow Gordon Ramsay with our specialist dish. Now then, kids, you are more than welcome to take part, but if you do, we'll need to keep a good watch on you. to ensure of your safety when it comes to what happens in the kitchen.
I like the idea of that, Dad. However, I think it might be a wise idea if us kids stayed out of the kitchen. We are more than happy to come up with decorations for the cake, but I personally don't think we should go anywhere near the equipment, let alone a hot oven.
I would actually like to take part in the preparation of the main dish, Romana. But you do have an excellent point when it comes to our safety around the oven. I'm sure we'll be able to come up with something that's kid-friendly.
I understand your concern, girls. So what I'll do is have you make decorations for the cake, and your mum and I will cook both dishes. How does that sound?
That's a brilliant idea, Dad. I appreciate that very much. At least we still get to help you out wherever we can. Come on, girls. Let's us go and get making the decorations for the cake.
That's a brilliant idea, my sweetness. We'll get to that right away.
Say, Millie, my saucy clam chowder. Have you thought of any ideas as to what we should cook for the main dish yet?
I haven't thought of that yet, my juicy cherry muffin. Maybe we should get our heads together and think of something. That's right. I think we should come up with a nice hearty soup, nothing too spicy, and make it nice and creamy for Gordon Ramsay.
That is a brilliant idea, my spicy sausage casserole. And then after that, we'll make a nice Victoria sponge for Anne and Dave to try. Just remembering what cookbooks we got our ideas from as well, and also making sure to add some form of twist to each dish too.
Absolutely, my summer peach bake well. So, without further ado, let's get cooking and having a great time.